Welcome back to our channel, guys! For today's vlog, we will discuss what is ethnocentrism and relativism, that is in Lesson 3. What then is the difference between the two? Well, I know that we are all familiar with these terms, but we will figure it out on the following slides. What do we really mean when we say ethnocentrism and relativism? Ethnocentrism means judging another culture solely by the values and standards of one's own culture. This happens when a person tries to judge the culture of other people from the point of view of their own culture. They can look at things like language, custom, religion, and behavior. People who are into ethnocentrism, we call them as ethnocentric. And ethnocentric individuals judge other groups relative to their own ethnic group or culture. An ethnocentric person will use their own culture as the basis for judging other cultures because they see their own culture as the best and believe other cultures should change to be more like theirs. Next is, ethnic distinctions and subdivisions serve to define each ethnicity's unique cultural identity. Because through these ethnic distinctions and subdivisions, identifying our differences from one another is made possible. We got to differ Filipinos from Americans because of its unique cultural practices. According to William G. Sumner, ethnocentrism is the technical name for the view of things in which one's own group is the center of everything, and all others are scaled and rated with reference to it. In other terms, the practices of a certain group is the center of everything or superior, and all others are just simply inferior, like that. Moreover, in the study of anthropology, ethnocentric are people born into a particular culture and grow up absorbing the values and behaviors of the culture, and then later on develops a worldview that considers their culture to be the norm or the standard among everything. If people then experience other cultures that have different values and normal behaviors, they will find that the thought patterns appropriate to their birth culture are not appropriate to the new culture. However, since people are accustomed to their birth culture, it can be difficult for them to see the behaviors of people from a different culture from the viewpoint of that culture rather than from their own. Examples of ethnocentrism include religious-centric constructs claiming a divine association like divine nation, one nation under God, God's own country, God's chosen people, and God's promised land. I have here another example for us to really comprehend what is ethnocentrism. Perfect! Really, no cuisine is as good as ours. Her belief that her cuisine is the best is a classic example of ethnocentrism. And believe it or not, this is common among Filipino people, especially those who are in the industry, right? Moving on to cultural relativism, it is the principle that an individual's beliefs and activities should be understood by others in terms of that individual's own culture. It means that the ideas, values, knowledge, and behavior of people must be understood within their own cultural context and not go beyond that. It's like it stays on that specific framework. Cultural relativism was established as accepted in anthropological research by Franz Boas in the first few decades of the 20th century and later popularized by his students. Cultural relativism was in part a response to Western ethnocentrism, and ethnocentrism consciously believes that one's arts are the most beautiful, values the most virtuous, and believes the most truthful. Boas first articulated the idea in 1887, saying, "Civilization is not something absolute, but is relative, and our ideas and conceptions are true only as far as our civilization goes. It is not absolute, but relative, because as far as our civilization goes, there are different interpretations of our ideas and conceptions that we people got to observe or relate upon." However, Boas did not coin the term. Then Franz Boas argued that one's culture may mediate and thus limit one's perceptions in less obvious ways. Since there is a tendency when a person got used to of that culture and he likes it, he might not see the other side of the coin or the other aspects of that culture. He understood culture to include not only certain tastes in food, art, and music, or beliefs about religion. He assumed a much broader notion of culture, defined as the totality of the mental and physical reactions and activities that characterize the behavior of the individual composing a social group collectively and individually. Meaning, culture accompanies a broader relation. Example, the natural environment, to other groups, to members of the group itself, and of each individual to himself. This understanding of culture confronts anthropologists with two problems. First is how to escape the unconscious bonds of one's own culture, and second, how to make sense of an unfamiliar culture. Now let us have the generalization of everything we've been talking. So ethnocentrism is the tendency to assume that one's own culture and way of life represent the norm or the standard, or it is superior among everything, the culture that you have been practicing. On the other hand, cultural relativism is the viewing of people's behavior from the perspective of their own culture. Just like what you see in the picture, when in Rome, do as the Romans do. It's like you put yourself in someone's shoe. Let us end this vlog with a quotation from M. Scott Pick. "The key to community is the acceptance, in fact, the celebration of our individual and cultural differences. It is also the key to world peace." Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you learned something, and see you all in our next vlog.